Ask better questions. Steve here with the Janitorial Store, the channel where we help cleaning business owners scale their businesses with system, tools, and resources. Well, you know, asking better questions or asking, you know, good questions is really the key to gathering the information that we need in order to price an account or a job. And the thing is that, you know, oftentimes people aren't asking very good questions, so that's why, you know, I'm saying ask better questions. In order to do that, you know, you want to take the time and write out some questions ahead of time, and you know, tailor them to your own personality. So you know, you'll start to memorize them, and you'll be able to start to use them freely throughout your conversation when you're talking to a prospect. But you know, the one thing that you have to do is you have to understand their expectations. So ask some questions about that. You know, about their expectations. Now, how many cleaners have they had in the past? Well, what happened that now they're looking for another cleaner? Were they not just doing a quality job? You know, what happened that they're looking for another cleaner? So we got to set the expectations. If we understand their expectations, then we should be able to fulfill those. Okay. Now you also have to find out, you know, how much area are you going to be cleaning? Very important. You know, the square footage of the area is very, very important. So you can always ask that question, but also let the prospect know that if they're not sure, in either way, you're going to measure the floor space anyway to know what exactly the square footage is. But that's a very, very important question. Now, something else that many people don't ask, you know, we have to find out how many people are involved in the decision-making process. You know, because many times we're not talking to the decision maker, and it's because we didn't qualify that person. So think about that question. You know, you may ask the question, is there anybody else involved in the decision making process? You know, and hopefully they'll be honest with you and tell you, you know, yes or no. I've had instances where the person had told me no, but here to find out they lied to me, and there's actually another person that was making the decision. That happens. So, you know, you can kind of press them on that by doing some follow-up questions to that, too, just to make sure that you're clear. Now, the other thing that you got to do is that you have to find out the frequency of service. Are we cleaning it? Is this a one-time job? Are we cleaning it once a week? Is it reoccurring? Once a week? Twice a week? 3 days a week? 4 days a week? 7 days a week? How what's the frequency of cleaning? So we need to know that. You know, another great question that you can ask about budget. We have to establish if this is price driven or not, and that's probably one of the questions that you should be able to formulate in many different ways to find out if it is price driven. Something else we got to do is that we have to know about the scope of work. So again, we can frame that question in a number of different ways to find out about the scope of work. If they don't have a scope of work, then you be prepared with your general list of a scope of work for that particular type of job. If it's an office, or if it's a medical center, or if it's a daycare or hair salon, you know, have your scope of work ready for that. And just have a general list of scope of work. Don't get carried away and start thinking you need to have a customized list. That just gets confusing to your cleaners and everybody else. So just keep it simple. So, you know, you want to think about that. And you know, if you don't have questions, or you're having a hard time creating a list of questions, well, go to the download library on the Janitorial Store or My House Cleaning Biz, and you're going to find pages of questions. So you download those and go through them. Like I say, there's pages of them. I created pages of questions. You know, and there are various types of questions. It could be qualifying questions, closing questions, you know, but there's pages of them. Go through there and see which ones, you know, that you like. Pull those out. You can rewrite them the way that you want to present them. And when you're reading through them, you might have some of these questions that might just spark, you know, how you might phrase it to somebody. Well, do that. You know, make them your own. Because, you know, asking these good questions, or asking better questions, is really what we have to do. We have to gather the information and be able to know that we're getting the proper information from somebody. So we do that by asking better questions. So, well, hopefully you got some value from this video. And if you did, feel free to comment or leave a like. And if you have not already, make sure that you subscribe. And make sure you turn on those bell notifications to get the latest updates of new videos that will help you grow your cleaning business. So, thanks for checking in, and let's keep it clean out there.